Hi there, my name is Dimitri from Tactiq. Have you ever tried to take meeting notes and what you end up finding is that you're really distracted because you're trying to focus on what the person's saying, you're trying to focus on what you're writing down or typing out, and you just find yourself during the meeting discombobulated by the time it's over? Well, I think what you need is a tool that is absolutely necessary in today's modern landscape. With all the online meetings you have, it's important to have all of the things people say documented, and it's actually easier to do than ever now. This is how to automate meeting notes with a dynamic AI notes app. Let's dive right into it. So Tactiq.io is our product. We are powered by OpenAI, and what we love to show you when working with us at Tactiq is how you can actually take your different meetings and augment it in a way that you never thought possible. So previously, when I was using Tactiq on my own workflows, what I would be able to do is I could go into any meeting and afterwards do AI prompts to create a short summary afterwards, or use any of the AI quick prompts up here to get AI-driven insights from the meeting. This is because the entirety of the meeting was set up here for success, because every single thing that was said by everyone in the call was transcribed and then added to this Tactiq transcript. I was able to see these notes in real time, and those notes were then able to be ported over into our great product. And while augmenting these transcription notes with AI is very beneficial, what's even more beneficial than having to go through and manually doing it yourself is to utilize our new workflows feature. Workflows is a really cool product that allows you to not only have your meeting notes transcribed, but as you can see with a breadth of different options here, you can actually have those meeting notes AI prompted automatically once the meetings are over. All right, so now what we can do inside of workflow templates is set up something really nice. So you'll see we have a template here, and what this template can do is it can take you through a specific process in order for whatever you usually do to be made really easy. So what I have on my team is a workflow that I like to do where after a meeting is over, I like to send them a short summary of the meeting. And I usually do review the meeting notes, have it make a short summary with Tactiq, double check that it looks good, and then send it out via email or whatever other product. And luckily for us, we have a template here that makes it really easy. We're integrating a lot of different products right now. You'll see examples of Slack in the future and other products to that regard. But what we have currently to show you here is an example of an email that we could send out. All right, so I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna say, subject, follow up summary on meeting. And then if you click on variables and examples, you'll see that the title of the meeting is something we can grab. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure, let's make this sizing a little bit bigger. Okay, meeting title. So let's just say, hey, team, here is the summary of our meeting title. And then what we can do is we can make sure that step two's output gets showcased here. And then below it say, thank you all so much for attending. See you in the next meeting, or something to that effect. All right, so you could add pretty much anything you want from previous variables here. It's really cool that you can actually do this, whether it be grabbing the title, the link to the meeting in Tactiq. I think this is a great option too. You could also put best, and then from the person who's sending the email, which is me. So best and then name. All right. So if I press save here, and then what we're going to do now is we're going to go into one of our meetings. All right. We can click on run workflow, and we're going to click on this one, the write a summary, review it, and send via email. Let's click on that. As you can see, it's going through the process of doing that. It's building the response, and then it's going to ask me whether or not I think it looks good, because there was a review step that's put in there. All right, so you're saying, do I want to accept it or not? This is an accurate summary. All right, I can press accept. And you'll see if I go back into activity and go into this automation, there's a difference between the builder section and the activity. It shows that this did send out. Pro tip, you don't actually have to go to the workflow section itself. You can also press run and then just click on one of them. So if I click on this myself, you'll see that it'll run through the workflow here. And then if I press accept once again, it's going to go through the rest of the workflow. And I think it's really cool that it also shows the amount of time that each different step took. And if you are interested in trying out more of these amazing different modules, there are so many different steps and directions you can go. You can not only pick those templates, but you can build out your own workflows. And if you're looking for more info on how to do all that, make sure to subscribe and like, because we're going to break down a lot of the different things you can do within this and with specific use cases as well. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. We appreciate your time, and we'll see you in the next one.